Hello everyone, this is very good old neighbor Nicky composing to an old Pelada fan to that one, you know. And I really hope you enjoy my We Do movie review on Nightfall, aka one of the most funniest comedy movie of 2019. I almost say 1999, but it didn't came out because it came out 2019 because my brain is so stupid. So anyway, because this movie, honestly, today, I really hope you enjoyed my movie review on the Crease movie, and now it's time to do a review on the sequel. Because, sadly, this movie is not directed by the same guy that he did a Black Panther movie, and Wakanda Forever, and Crease 2015. I bought this film directed by the same guy that he's going to direct another Transformers movie. Because I really hope Harry Steinfeld will be in that. Because I really hope that movie be way better than the sequel, Transformers by Michael freaking Bay. So anyway, guys, so today, So today I'm doing a movie review on Crease 2, Commedio of 2018, because this film came out the same day of the most overrated Disney movie, which is none other than Wreck-It Ralph 2, aka Ralph Break the Internet. Which honestly is kind of sad that this movie is getting it's getting mixed review, and Wreck-It Ralph 2 got more great review than Crease 2. And yeah, I think Crease 2 is much better than Wreck-It Ralph 2. If you don't like me saying that, just write me in a comment, all I care. Anyway, I don't want to tell a story because let's talk about this movie before, etc. Anyway, my thought on the Crease 2015, this is honestly one of my third favorite movie of 2015. That movie is groundbreaking, it's gruesome, it's violent. That movie is honestly one of my favorite boxing movie ever made, and that movie is way better than every Rocky movie came out in the 90s, 80s, and the 70s. And sorry guys, so after I watched this movie, after I ate McDonald's for lunch, after I watched this movie for the first time, and this movie is so much better than Wreck-It Ralph 2. Main reason why I'm saying that, because this movie came out the same day of Robin Hood 2018, which that movie sucks, Major Donkey Ball, and Wreck-It Ralph 2, which I cannot believe I used to love that movie, but now I think that movie is a huge overrated, and that was honestly one of the worst movie out of the Disney revival era, and Frozen 2 is much better than Wreck-It Ralph 2. So if you want, if you want to hear more detail about Wreck-It Ralph 2, I recommend you check out my video called Why Wreck-It Ralph 2 is a Cinematic Disaster. And honestly, I know this thumbnail is a rip-off to the other YouTuber, which honestly, I really enjoy making disaster thumbnail. I really love it because I like making characters, making funny faces, which that is pure comedy, and people don't like that. People call it the rip-off, which a lot of people hate fun nowadays, so I'm getting sick and tired of it. Anyway, this is honestly one of the most underrated November movie of 2018. Because this movie is groundbreaking, just like the first movie. And this is honestly one of my second favorite boxing movie ever made, because this movie is very fantastic. Do I have any criticism about this film? Well, I think the little runtime is pretty long, because it kind of reminds me of watching the 3-hour movies. But anyway, this is honestly one of the longest Crease movies I have ever seen for Crease movies. Just like the first movie, because the first movie, it was a 2-hour movie. But this movie feel like I am watching a 3-hour movie. So on top of that, because this movie is really great, because it's, crap. You keep censoring in your 9th-hour review, quick stomp for censoring. Back I was saying, a part of this film is honestly one of the longest November movie of 2018, because this film is kind of reminding me of watching the 3-hour movie like Return of the King and Zack Snyder's Justice League. Even Zack Snyder's Justice League is a 4-hour movie, no pun intended. And so anyway, and even this movie is going to get a 10 out of 10, but the only nitpick has to be the runtime, which the runtime is feel like a 3-hour movie. But anyway, that's all I got to say. It's just like the tiny, tiny, tiny nitpick. Yep, tiny nitpick, just like what I said in my scene rant. So yeah. And so anyway guys, the story of the film is really great. And the characters, honestly, we already know about the character. And the villain of the film is really awesome. And honestly, I actually cried in this movie, because while I was watching, when the villain was really upset and his coach said, "It's okay." And honestly, it made me want to cry, man, because honestly, I feel so bad about the villain, you know, because he was trying to win the boxing, but Michael B. Jordan is trying to beat the crap out of him, anyway. Anyway, guys, and Silver Stone, Silver Stone, which honestly, he's a really great character as Rocky. And Rocky in this film, he honestly, once again, he's a really great character in this movie. And Tessa Thompson, once again, she did a really good job in this movie. I don't want to remember in 2020 when she defended that the most disgusting movie on Netflix, which is Naked and Cuties. Oh my god. Ugh, I hate that movie. Sorry about that, guys. I had to say cutie with the goofy voice, which there's nothing cutie about that, more disgusting. Anyway, guys, let's talk about this. Anyway, and then the cinematography of the film looked absolutely brilliant. This is honestly one of the best looking I ever seen for a boxing movie, because this movie is very fantastic. And the violence of this movie, this is honestly one of the most gruesome violent I ever seen in 2018. It's even violent just like the Avengers Infinity War and Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Even Spider-Verse is a kid's movie, but it has some gruesome violence in that movie too. Anyway. Just like when Kingpin just punched Maya Morales, so yeah. And so, hey guys, in the ending of the film. The ending of the film is really great, and I cannot wait to see Creed 3 in 2023. So overall, guys, Creed 2, this is a underrated gem. This movie is so much better than Robin Hood and Wild Break the Internet, aka Wreck-It Ralph 2, aka the most overrated Disney movie I have seen in my life. And so, yeah, I don't care what Inside Out Fan 2001 said, but this film is way better than Wreck-It Ralph 2. And I am giving Creed 2 a 10 out of 10. This is an epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I am giving this boxing movie a seal of Nick Hick awesomeness. Michael B. Jordan! So, yeah, that was my movie review on Creed 2. Tell me what you thought of this movie on the comment section below without a spoiler. And sorry guys, I do remember when I said I'm gonna rewatch Frozen, and yeah, I'm not gonna rewatch that because I made myself a deal. I am never, ever, ever gonna rewatch that overrated piece of crap. So yeah. Yeah, I'm not gonna rewatch Frozen. I'm just gonna rewatch some Disney movie. That's all I'm gonna do. Not rewatching Frozen, because I refuse to rewatch Frozen, because that movie's for gores. Because Frozen 2 is for everyone for all ages, but I'm just saving my watch for Frozen 2 Watch Along Party. So stay tuned on December 1st. Stay tuned for my Watch Along Party live stream about Frozen 2. I really hope my Watch Along Party will be way better than 2020, because that live stream for Watch Along Party about Frozen 2, because I got copyrighted by Pixar, because my brother Chris was watching Finding Nemo, and now Finding Nemo just got my video copyright. Doing your Finding Nemo. Even Finding Nemo is a masterpiece, but I was just so angry that my Frozen 2 Watch Along Party got copyright strike because of Pixar Animation Studio. And sorry guys, I'm not gonna blame my Disney, because Disney is doing their thing, but anyway, I'm just gonna blame my Bob, because Bob don't know what the monkey did do, and thank God he got fired. Thank God, because now Disney can go back to the glorious day. And so, hey guys, if you like this Michael B. Jordan video, please, I recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn the notification, and share it with your whole family. And honestly, maybe give you some quick update, because if I don't see Creed 3 in theater, because I don't normally see boxing movie in theaters, I might wait until we'll be online on HETACC, because I really want to watch that movie. So yeah. So if I don't, I might wait on digital and then etc. Anyway, I'm probably the digital nowadays or coming pretty early, since it came out in theaters anyway. Anyway, guys, in 2023, stay tuned for my movie review on Creed 3, because Creed 3 is going to come out. It's going to come out in theaters next year, so I cannot wait. It's honestly one of the most anticipated boxing movie ever, so I'm really looking forward to see Creed 3. I really hope Rocky will be in the third movie, because I just heard a rumor that Rocky was not going to be a third movie. I just heard a rumor that Rocky is not going to be in the third movie. So what's the point of making Creed movie without Rocky? You gotta make a Creed movie with Rocky. If you make a third movie without him, Creed 3 is not gonna be as good as Creed 1 and 2. But I think Creed 3 will be a guilty pleasure. But after I saw the trailer, I am so looking forward to that. And speaking of that, stay tuned for my trailer style of Frozen 2 of Creed 3. So maybe think about it. For the meantime, guys, subscribe, comment, share the video with your family. Couple more days until Christmas review week will be open. It will be closed on December 26th. And so, hey guys, I see you next time. And so, welcome to PG2. Have a good day, everyone. And I see you guys tomorrow afternoon, because honestly, I'm just gonna make some random video, like my question video and then etc. And honestly, I might do my last live stream tonight. So stay tuned. So get your notification ready. Time for another live stream after dinner. And sorry guys, I'm not rewatching Frozen 2013. The movie's overrated, so I don't want to make Frozen angry. I'm just going to rewatch some Disney movie back in the day. That's all I gotta do, except rewatching Frozen, because that movie's a huge overrated crap. So yeah. Have a great day, everyone, and I see you guys next time, and have a great afternoon.